What is up, Giants fans? It's your boy Jay Damson. We are back with another banger. But before we get to this one, make sure you leave a like on the video. Help spread the video out. Help get it more out there. Get more people looking at it. And we can just gain and grow together as a fam, as a gang. You already know the vibes, man. Now let's hop into it. We're grading the pick today. We're grading the Kadarius Toney selection. Well, my first reaction, personally, it was a surprising pick. It was a very surprising pick. Even the Giants fans that love this pick, which I do, found the pick very surprising. You know, you trade back to 20. There's been reports of the Giants wanting a edge rusher at 11, but they knew that if you take an edge rusher at 11, you know, there's going to be a big backlash to the from the fans. So you trade back. You trade back. No wide receivers on the board at 11. You trade back. And then you see that Kwity Paye is still on the board. Only one edge rusher had gotten taken off the board at the time. That was Jalen Phillips of the Miami Dolphins at 18. Then they go Kadarius Toney over a Kwity Paye, over a Tevin Jenkins, over a Azeez Ojulari. That was a surprising pick. And I feel like a lot of people are taking that surprise of a pick and ruling it as a bad selection for the Giants. And I just don't feel that way. I feel like this pick from the Giants was a B-plus pick. It was a B-plus pick. I'll be lying if I said it was an A, because I don't feel like, me personally, I had him mocked going to the Packers around like, what, 30, around that range, the Packers, or even early second round. I didn't have him going this early, but I feel like it's still a good pick. If the Giants wanted Jalen Waddle in the draft and he got taken ahead of them, you basically got another player like Jalen Waddle. I don't see what's the problem with that. If the Giants wanted a wide receiver that was, what, like a Jalen Waddle, and they couldn't get Jalen Waddle, Kadarius Toney, in my opinion, was the best next option to that. Elijah Moore is debatable, but outside of that, I find Kadarius Toney a better prospect than Rondale Moore. I feel that way personally. Rondale Moore dealt with injury issues a lot at Purdue. He really he's not really that diverse of a route runner like Kadarius Toney. Kadarius Toney is a good route runner, just that a lot of his routes are like freestyle routes. He'll do double cuts and stuff like that. Kadarius Toney is a good football player, and I feel like a lot of people are underrating this draft selection. But then you have those other people like Bingle, who is actually understanding how good Kadarius Toney is as a football player. It's some Giants fans out here bashing him and saying that this wasn't a good pick. Me personally, I feel like Kadarius Toney's like a Deebo Samuel. I feel like he's a Deebo Samuel, a guy who can catch the ball, who can run the ball, who just, when he gets the ball in his hands, he's looking for the end zone. Kadarius Toney is so dynamic. He's a playmaker. He's what the Giants needed. You know, Kenny Galladay is our go up and get it wide receiver. Darius Slayton's our deep threat. Sterling Shepard's our intermediate route runner. You know, just good, reliable hands there. Then you got Kadarius Toney, who is someone who's good in the intermediate, someone who's a deep threat, someone who can take the ball off the take the top off the defense. That's what the Giants needed. This was a good pick by Dave Gettleman. Now, I'm giving it a B-plus without even ruling in that the trade back that happened. I'm not even ruling that in. I'm not ruling in the compensation that they got from trading back to pick 20. I'm not even ruling that in. I'm not. So if I was to rule that in, I would give this pick a solid A. But I'm not going to do that. I'm going to grade it based off of the pick alone. The Giants select Kadarius Toney with the 20th overall pick, and I like it. I like the pick. If you are feeling some way about the pick, you're entitled to your own opinion. I can't make you like the pick overnight. I think the pick has to grow on a few people. The pick grew on me quick, because I knew about Kadarius Toney. I just wasn't expecting Kadarius Toney in the first round. That's all it was to me. I wasn't expecting Kadarius Toney in the first round. You know what I'm saying? But as I sat back, looked at it from a clear eye view, I slept on it. I started looking at some more highlights, some more tape of him. And I said, hey, this boy actually kind of nice, man. Go watch some of the film. Go watch some of the tape. The dude is nice. If he wants to run you over, if he wants to run through you, he'll try to run through you. If he don't want to run through you, if he don't feel like running through you that time, he'll use his knees and just break you down and just go past you. That's what he does. He makes defenders look silly when they're trying to tackle him. And I like that from Kadarius Toney. You can line him up all over the field. You want to line him up at running back? Throw him in at running back some plays. If you want to do an in route, go ahead, do an in route. That's how versatile, that's how dynamic he is as a football player. And I feel like he's exactly what the Giants was missing. So I'll give this draft pick a B plus. You know what I'm saying? This is before he even gets on the field. This is before he gets on the field. You can't really give your full evaluation, your full grade on a player or on a draft selection until you see what they do on the field. But until then, I'm gonna give this pick a solid B plus. I like this pick from the Giants. Kadarius Toney, pick 20th overall. I like it, and that's really it. So we're gonna see what they do today, though, in the second and third round, man. Maybe a trade up. I want him to trade up for Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoah. I want him to do that. He's still on the board. We'll see how it all plays out, and that's really gonna do it, man. Y'all guys be safe. We out. Go Giants.